Maybe it's... So maybe this is 11. Times what? Oh! Sometime after one of the spheres was last pressed against the door, two metal plates screech slowly to one side. The door is open. After the spheres? What spheres? These spheres underneath the cursor here? So wait. We got it right. I'm making a note. I am making a mental note. Well, not a mental note. I'm making a written note. Okay, so this is... So then the orange, I think, is 10. So I want to write this down. So... Orange... Is that... Wait, that's not even orange. That's red, isn't it? Yeah. Alright. Scribble that out. Red. Orange. Red. Red. I don't even know for sure. I put that it was 22, right? Because red is 1, and orange is 10. And all I did was multiply, even though it's two circles, sorry about the clicking, I don't know what's going on there. So the two circles, I think, would be multiplied twice, but maybe not. So that's a good clue. We figure that out. Could possibly get inside the chamber inside the test mine now as well with that information. But, well, we're here and we don't have an easy way to get out. Now, if there's monsters in here, that's not going to make any sense. Because they would have been locked in here all this time. But there shouldn't be anything in here. What is that? I don't know what that is. Teleport circle or something? What's over here? Oh! Another thing to power the amber, to put the amber in. Importante. Power that up in a second. I just want to see what this thing is all about. Clickety click. Nothing happens. Pokey poke. Nothing happens. Okay. Close enough. Can we get closer? A little closer? There we go. The piece of amber activates the secret unit. Oh. This one's a secret unit. Oh! Wow! What does this do? Yes, I'm saving again. Oh! That's a way out. Seen that? Tempted to go back and oh, this has been covered by rubble. What the hell, man? The gate that was here is covered by rubble. What is the meaning of this? So now the way out is here. I think we can get this close without falling. Everyone else is gonna get hurt. Boom. Actually, didn't hurt anybody. So, are we in the same spot? We're down. No, we're down here. Okay. This is stupid. I'm gonna load. We can't find our way back in yet. Again. Alright, let's not go through there until we're done. How about that? I don't know what happened there. The gate was covered up and there was another gate where we could see, somehow, a place that we had not been, with a gate at the end. I don't understand. But maybe we don't have to understand right now, we'll just go on our merry way. So we have a gate here we haven't been through. I'm gonna hold off on that. Did we go... Where are we? It's this way. Did we go in this room? I think so. Oh yeah, it's just showing us... more... symbols. Okay, so then what about over here? Oh, there's a lot of them here. Boy. Oh, monsters. Oh, hi! You look very pixelated that close. Oh, I gotta get my protections up. Our protections up. Let loose the whirlwind. Alright, so magical barrier. I didn't check the walls. There might be a way through those walls. into the other area. It doesn't make sense. I wonder if it's some kind of bug. Haven't heard of that bug, but... doesn't mean it doesn't exist. Gizzeks moving, sleep spell, Citrine? And somebody else, maybe? Valden? Valden's asleep. Oh, they're all casting sleep. Ah, and they're hitting me with sleep. Okay, then I'm asleep. There's three of us asleep. Guess Edge will be the... okay. Let's... wake up... Citrine. He's fallen asleep too. Yeah, both of these. Okay, we're awake for now. Maybe we should just forget about it and put the magic protection up first. So we can resist the sleep spells a little bit. Stop deflecting! I don't like that. Aren't they deflecting and still taking damage? I guess they're taking partial damage. Or is it lag because this thing's so slow right now? Ouch. Oh, Valden woke up because they hit him. Ah, here we go again. Nelvin's asleep. Alright. Let's get the anti-magic wall up. Oh. She's gotta move. Nelvin's sleeping. Ugh. If I didn't have to move her, I'd wake up Nelvin. Just checking everyone's equipment. We still have it. Clicking OK. Yeah, we don't like you going after our healer lady. I have to try to cast my spell here. Someone tries to put me to sleep. It's like they're all just attacking. Ah! The spell failed! How dare you! Anti-magic wall, I insist. Let's wake up Nelvin. Nice. Down to four. spell failed. I appreciate that. I was drinking something and I saw that our anti-magic actually went up. Now let's go for the magical barrier. Edge will attack this one. Nelvin will do the whirlwind thingy. Sabine will wake up. Who was really? Oh god. Walden. Okay, never mind. Let's do a medium healing on Walden. Glad I did a little checking around. See if anyone needed healing. And Walden's down to 80 points. Better. Oof. We'll thrash you good. Wow. I hate to keep healing him. I want to wake up Selena, but I don't want to have Walden end up dead. Move him over. Throw another whirlwind. And I can get the magical assault up. In theory. Okay, Walden almost full. Poof! And then there were two. Poof! And then there was one. Nice, we got them all up. Just in time for the fight to be over. Let's wake up Selene, or Selena, right before the battle ends. Paltry XP. All right. Anything else in here to hound us? To hound our every move. Still, I don't know what they're doing with this. I mean, what's the line mean? So these are... The red triangles are 1. So it's 10 over... 10 over 10. Is that what that means? They're teaching us... They're teaching us here. That... I guess the line might be an equal sign. There's 5 and 5 here, so this 10 equals one of these, 10. So I guess these things are also using a base of 10. Which means whoever they probably have 5 fingers on each hand. Either that or one hand with 10 fingers, but they're using the same base that we are. They're using a base 10. Which I guess is good to know. It could be worse. What was it? Star Trek? I don't know if it was the 25th anniversary, those adventure games. Or the other one, Judgment Rites, I think it's called. They used a base of something other than 10, and that was kind of difficult to figure out. So, if we're using base 10 here as well, ain't no big thing. So I just want to look at the other... Yeah, we had it right before that. Yeah, let's look at here as well. Let's see if that coincides. Because here they tell you... I mean, where would they be teaching you about math? Is this place a school? Used to be a school? See, because these are yellow, right? Look how pale they are. In comparison to... these, yeah. So... we don't have a frame of reference here because we don't know what the yellow or the blue equals. I'm assuming the blue would have a higher value. Which does make sense because blue, like I was saying earlier, blue is the hottest flame. Of course, I don't know what's... I think red is relatively cool, all things considered. So we've also got another little lesson here. So let's go over there and see... and we can piece together what all the symbols mean. Maybe. I hope. Ah, yes, yes, yes. Okay. So the orange is 10. Right. So this equals this. So then the yellow is 50. Hope I'm right about this, because I feel really smart right now. Yellow is 50. I'm gonna just... yeah, hold on. I'm making a new thing here, because... okay, so red is 1. Orange is 10. Yellow is 50. If I'm remembering right from the other room, 2 yellows equal a blue, so then the blue is 100. Still have to open that other door. I'm just like going to school here. I forget, is it? It's in here. Yeah, I see him. Pretty cool, I can see it from so far away. Okay, so the yellow is 50. Clicking. So 2 50s. 2 yellows equal a blue. 2 50s equal 100. So I think we'll have the number for the... what do you call it? I'm sorry about the clicking. Whenever I move my head, which I sometimes have to do, it clicks. Alright, so we know what all those mean, at least until we come across some other symbol, which... color symbol, which I don't know if we will or not. And I think this is not the way out of here. Nope. Alright, so... he was right, the dwarf. He was right in what he said. Alright, so I want to come out of here and hang a left. Right, that's that room. So normally I'm horrible at math, so I feel really good about myself right now. Alright. Oh, this one's broken. Could there have been a multiplier here? A circle? Or are you missing a symbol, maybe? I'm gonna take it at face value for right now. So I'm gonna say red is 1... Orange is 10, so that's 11. And then 50. 61. Alright? In case you're not following, 1, 10, 50. Just in case something horrible happens as soon as we open the door. So we're on episode 178 now. Which number? 61? Ah! The door is open. You stride forth. What's that stuff? That's to get back out? Same symbol. Well, collection of symbols. What's that? Oh. Under this unidentifiable rotten pile of rubbish, there was a piece of raw amber. Ooh, I'll take it. What about this rubbish? Allowed to decay for ages, the unknown objects fall to dust at the slightest touch. Oh. That they do. So we just came in here to get another piece of amber? We have so much amber already. Oops. There's more. Is this the one I just looked at? I think so. There's another here. Dust again. I wonder if there's any secret, you know, illusory walls, I think. Because if so, there might be one to the east side. It's a little extra area there, isn't there? No, no, we can't pass through. So we got in here just for amber. Is that it? Is it for the underground? But no, the only problem is once we leave, I don't know how to get back through. There's another area. I think it's here that we travel? Or here? Let me look over there. One second. Where the hell am I? Okay, we're heading... No, west. That's west. I see an exit. Maybe that's where it is. Wait, where are we? Oh, we can go back up here. I am the leader. Saving again. Because I don't... What if we go up here and things are not as they should be? Alright, we're going up. Okay, good. Now we're on this side, we can explore some more. Maybe. Daylight streams through a hole in the ceiling. Oh. We can just get out this way. What about secret walls and stuff? We can levitate our way out. This way. The panel in the center of this strange device moves down gently as soon as you stand on it. Oh, this is this thing. Is that really all that's to be found here? It's a perfect rectangle except for this bit here. So we can't clear this. We have to levitate out. Just out of curiosity, I'm just trying to see if we can clear it on this side. That's what the dwarf said he did, right? He went up. Up top. Oh. I wasted it. That's stupid. All right. I clicked the wrong thing. I meant to click the shovel or whatever. I just want to see if I can clear it. Probably not. Shovel? Pickaxe didn't work. Crowbar? Another crowbar. See, I don't feel bad. Kind of save scumming for that. Because it doesn't really make sense in context of the game. That he would try to use a rope there when trying to use a shovel. So in real, in not real world terms, but in the game world sense, doesn't make any sense that something like that would happen. Yeah, I don't see a way through. So we gotta levitate up, which is fine by me. So he... Ugh, my god, excuse me. Oh, there was the... So, it's funny, it looks like it's his arm chopped off. He climbed the outside wall. There were Gizzeks up there, apparently. Alright. So, we'll get out this way. Levitation, levitation, levitation. Oh.